Mixed media can be quite intimidating, but it's just what you make it to be. And it doesn't have to be hard at all. It's a great way to explore new techniques and play with your supplies. Come join me and see how I make a simple layered art journal page. So let's get to it. I'm going to use an Art by Marlan stencil that I used in the previous video. And I'm going to work on my Joggles art journal pages, which are disc bound so I can take them out, which makes them way less intimidating to work on instead of having a complete journal to play with. And then I'm going to add some texture paste. This is a nice thick paste that is very easy to apply, and it spreads a bit like peanut butter to compare it with food. So I'm adding the paste in a few spots. If you want to learn more about how to work with stencils and paste, I have a free guide that you can download. It's in the description box below. This paste doesn't need a lot of drying time, and I'm going to use some sprays, so I can do that basically right away. So I add the spray in a few different spots. I want one page a little bit more on the bluish peacock color side and the other page a little bit more purple. Then I spray some water to activate the oxide ink to blend the colors and to spread them out a little bit more. I'm also going to use the heat tool, and I put some kitchen paper underneath my papers so the color that's dripping off can leak on that and it doesn't get on the other side, so my pages don't get soaked through and through. You can also let this air dry. You don't have to use the heat tool, but the heat tool definitely does speed things up a bit. Now my pages are pretty warped and I press them down a little bit while I'm drying them. The pages will flatten out more once they are completely dry, and I like to use my make art station to get it completely flat also. So there are a few lighter spots on the background, and I'm adding a bit more color there. And you can always come in and add a bit more color or spray some more water to dilute the colors a little bit more. And then just use your heat tool to dry, blot, and well, just play around a little bit until you like the background. So I'm spraying a little bit of water by squeezing the water bottle halfway so I get some drops. And this will give me some really cool texture, and you can let that dry or blot, and you can also do both. So let dry and blot to get some more color difference. And this will give you some super cool free texture, which is always a great thing to have. In case you want to check out the products I used, I have a supplies list in the description box below. So my pages are dry, and now I'm going to add a little bit more color using a brush because I want a little bit of the blue color also in the creases of the stencil pattern on the purple side. Then I spray some water and then I blot, so it's going to be very subtle. And this is a really fun way to play around to get the color exactly in the way you like it. On the other page, I'm adding the ink with the tube. Make sure to shake your bottles well before you start using them. This goes for spraying as well as for adding it with a brush or with the tube, so the color is mixed really well. Then I spray some more water to spread my color. And this will give you that pretty blended look, as well as it will activate your oxide inks. Then I have a stamp with some really cool circles and a really big flower that I absolutely love. And I'm going to add those stamps on the texture paste parts. So I'm using the striped stamp for that. Or the circle striped stamp, or is that a good name? Yeah, I think it's a good name. So I'm adding some texture there to add a little bit of black. Then I'm going to use an acrylic block with some of the other small stamps to add some tiny circles on the background. And I'm also stamping with black. Now this may look quite a harsh color right now, but it's going to be better and it's going to be really cool. I promise. Now remember, art journaling is just what you make it to be. It doesn't have to be hard. It's not like you have to do this or that, because otherwise it's not art journaling. It's your art journal and you can do whatever you want with it. So start really simple with some fun layers and do some doodling, or well, whatever you prefer best to do in your art journal. So after I added all my stamps, I'm going to add some color to the outside of the page. I'm using some black distress oxide ink. So I'm only adding the black color along the outside edges of the page. And I do this for both pages. And I leave the middle part, so where the binding is, I leave that open, so uncolored or just with the purple and the blue. When my two pages are done, I put them next to each other so I can make sure that they match in the middle, so the color is at about the same height, so they make a nice match. Then I'm going to add some white, and this will make those darker colors pop. Adding some white is also a great way to make the other colors on the page stand out. And in combination with some black, it's always a great way to add a bit of variation on your page and to make the other colors come out or bring out the other colors even more. And adding little details like this isn't only fun to do, because it's really relaxed to do like a sort of really simple coloring. It's also a great way to make the page your own and to add a really finishing touch to all those tiny elements. I also find that adding a bit of white will help the design come together a bit more. I went ahead, colored the piece of card with some Distress Oxide ink and stamped a bunch of shapes, and I fussy cut them. And now I'm going to add some white also to those shapes, which will make them stand out a bit more too. So I'm speeding things up a little bit because, well, it's pretty clear what I'm doing here, right? So I'm coloring the shapes on the outside with a little bit of the purple ink, and that will help them pop from that page because the background is also the blue, and adding that purple will make them stand out a little bit more instead of blending in with the background. Now I'm adding some of the purple color, and then I'm layering all the pieces on the background and I'm moving them back and forth to see where I want them. And I'm sort of going for a galaxy look with a flower, which is, well, your imagination, you can do anything. So I'm adding my shapes, and some I add over the edge, and also the blue on the purple will make it stand out a bit more because, well, that really pops, right? I'm just adding my shapes with the glue when I have them in place, and you can also use tape if you like that. I'm waiting with the bigger shape until I have all the pieces in place, so I know that's the exact spot where I want them. Now I decided that the middle of the flower could use some extra texture and another layer, of course. So I'm adding one of those bigger line shapes in the middle too. I'm adding a little bit more details in the heart of the flower, and then I'm going to glue my flower in place too. And now I'm going to add some outlines around all the shapes, and I'm going to make some lines and some dotted parts. So this is just a feeling thing. Just go with your feeling when you're adding some highlights. This will make the elements pop on your page a bit more. And it's also fun, sort of simple doodling. And adding lines and stripes also gives it a little bit of a playful effect. Adding those white outlines make the elements come together with the page more also. And I'm also adding some white details on the inside of my flower. And this will also help make those colors pop more. I'm just using a white gel pen, and you can use any white pen for this. Writing on the oxide inks is super simple, so that will work with different pens. I do like this pen because it basically always writes, which is very nice. Now I'm going to add some tiny dots here and there. You can also make some splats. But when you make some splats, you have to cover the rest of your page if you don't want your splats everywhere. And I want to go for really tiny bits, so I'm just adding some dots with the gel pen. And this will also add to that sort of galaxy planet look that I was going for. You also see me move back every now and then, or pause a little bit, and then I just take my page in and look at it from, well, a bit of a distance, not really far distance, but a bit of a distance, so you can better see the overall look of the complete page. Now I'm going to add a sentiment. I cut the letters out of a black cardstock that I added to a white strip. And I added a piece of double-sided adhesive to the back. I also have three of those little dots left over that I'm going to add underneath the word things. And this will help to bring those elements together also. And to make the sentiment blend in with the page more, I'm going to add some details with the white gel pen again. If you don't like art journaling, that's totally fine. You can use this idea for a card also. And it's just a pop on another sentiment, or maybe you like this sentiment for a card too. And then this will make a pretty card also. So always think in options instead of obstacles. And the last thing I'm going to do is to add some stickles in a purple color. And it's always good to add some glitter, in my opinion, because I love some glitter. And the background is, well, a bit chalky and dry looking, if that's a good way to describe it. And adding some glitter is always a nice touch to finish well about anything, I think. So here are the finished pages, and as you can see, they're quite easy to make. I have lots of details and there are quite some layers, but they are not hard to do, and it's so much fun to make a journal page like this. Are you ready to give it a go and start your own art journal or work on a page? Have lots of fun. If you do need some more inspiration, you can find some right here. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting.